Hello guys, welcome to JD Bots. In this video series, we are going to learn how to create a ToDo bot. So what do you mean by ToDo bot? So if you have any tasks to do, so you make a list of that task, and after you finish those tasks, you just mark it as completed or finished. So this approach you might be doing in some notebook, or you might be doing in calendars, or you might be doing in some Android applications if it has. So we are going to learn same thing using Microsoft Bot framework, and we are going to build a bot. So let's get started. I hope you have the Visual Studio installed on your system. And we are going to create a new project. So if you have installed the bot framework templates, then you will see that in the project types, a new project type is added, that is AI bots. So once you select that, you'll have the list of all the templates available. And currently the template is available for .NET Core 2.1 and .NET Core 3.1 version. We are going to use the core bot template and the .NET Core 3.1 version. Let's give a name of our bot. And also give the location where you want to save. Make sure you place the solution and the project file in the same directory. You have the bot ready with the template. So initially you'll see a warning sign on the dependencies. That means there are some dependencies which are getting installed. So in the left down corner you can see the status of the background task which is running. Here you'll see that some of the dependencies will be installed. And after it is done, this yellow warning marker will go away. Now it has started restoring the NuGet packages. NuGet packages are nothing but the libraries which are used in this project structure. So by the time the packages get installed, we can see the overall structure. Basically, this core bot is a flight booking bot template. You'll have the dialogues. You'll have a main dialogue and then a booking dialogue and cancel and help dialogue. So these are the various dialogues. But in our case, we don't need all of them. So for the today's context, we'll be filtering out the things which we don't need. We'll only keep those files which are required for our development purpose. Rest all we are going to delete it. The first thing which we don't need is the booking details. This I'm going to delete. As you can see, all the dependencies have installed and the yellow marker is not appearing as of now. So I'm going to delete the booking details. Also, from the dialogues, I'm going to delete the booking dialog, then date resolver dialog. I guess date resolver we can keep, because it might be helpful if you want to schedule something in your to-do bot, like note down an appointment for tomorrow. Okay, so I believe we can keep the date resolver dialog. And if at all you're trying to implement the Luis capabilities in your bot, Luis is nothing but the language understanding capabilities, which makes your bot more intelligent. So then we can keep the cancel and help dialog as well. So let's delete the booking dialog. This we don't want. Yeah, next cognitive models, we are going to, if time permits, or if we are trying to implement the Lewis capabilities, then we'll implement this cognitive model in the Lewis portal. We'll not implement locally. So let's delete that as well. Yeah, now you will see certain syntactical errors because we have removed so many files and we have the reference which is showing us error. So cognitive models, we are going to delete this import statement and we are going to remove this booking dialog as well from the constructor. And also the add dialog object. So this Lewis code we can keep it, but we'll modify it later. And act also we can keep it. I guess let's delete everything. We'll implement it freshly. Delete all the content inside the methods. And yeah, delete this method, which is not part of, this is not a part of the waterfall dialog model. And also delete this part. We'll need the last two statements because it allows us to restart the main dialog. Okay, as of now, this methods is showing me error because we have removed the return statement. Let's add some return statement, just return null, so that the error message will not be shown. And you will see, okay, we'll have to remove the flight booking recognizer as well. But I think this will be useful because if we are implementing the Lewis capabilities, then it allows us to get the intent and the entity from the Lewis portal. Yeah, I guess we can keep this, but we'll have to rename this. And we'll rename it as ToDo recognizer. Let's rename it as Lewis because it will be better understandable. And once you click enter, you'll have to change all the references. So you click on yes. What it will do, it will change the class name in the file as well. You see, ToDo Lewis recognizer. And here we don't have any errors. And let's go to startup.cs because there also we have some reference of booking dialog. Yeah, here it is. Just remove this part as well. See how intelligently this Visual Studio has changed all the references. Earlier it was that flight booking recognizer. Now since we have changed the name, here also it got changed. Actually it will change in the whole project structure. And then let's save all. Yeah, I think we are good to go. To check whether our code is error free, just debug and start without debugging. Oops. Sorry, it should not start without debugging. Since we are checking, just it should be build actually. Okay, let it be. It will start building now. Since we have removed the major content from our code, the bot will not work. but at least we'll know that there are no errors. Yeah, I think we are error free, and once you run the bot application, so it will open a web page and it will give the link to connect through bot emulator. So when we copy this link and open the bot emulator, and paste it here and connect. Bot, this Microsoft app ID and password are not required. Once you deploy it in the Azure, then we'll have to put it here. Otherwise, for the local development purpose, it's not required. So it will show us a welcome message, but after that it will show that some error has occurred. Yeah, see, the bot encountered an error or bug. But yeah, we can see the welcome message, and this is the default welcome message of Microsoft Bot Framework. Let's go ahead and change that too. Okay, to create a credit, that was the adaptive card. Actually, this is called adaptive card. We have an image, we have an header, then some body, then these are some actions, and the actions are the link. Let's create that. You'll have to go to adaptivecards.io/designer, and from here we can create our adaptive card. So the latest version is 1.3, but Microsoft Bot Framework supports, I think, 1.2, I believe. But in some of the cases, some of the card elements are not supported in Bot Framework. So we'll go ahead and select 1.1. I'm going to remove this portion, his photograph, and his name. Let's also remove this key. Okay, fine. So we'll replace this heading with ours, ToDo bot, and let's keep it in the center, and let's make it larger, extra large and bold. Color, let's keep it dark. Yeah, this looks nice, right? And let's replace the content as well. This bot will allow you to create, view, delete tasks. Looks good. This is a basic adaptive card I'm creating, but you can create much beautiful by adding some images. And set due date, I think that's not required. Let's where do you want to point your adaptive card to? Let's say I want to point to my website. All right, and the title should be Visit JD Bots. I think the content, okay, let's add an image, that will be much better, right? And let's search for some images, bot images, I guess. Yeah, this is a free image from Bing, so make sure you use those images which are copyright free. Actually, I'm going to copy the image address and paste it here. Oh, beautiful. Yeah, and alternate text if suppose the image is not able to be shown here, then we can place an alternate text bot image. Yeah, now it looks perfect. Okay, now after you create the adaptive card, just copy the JSON code and paste it in the welcome message, that is welcome card. So just replace this much, JSON. Earlier it was the 1.0 version, now we are using the 1.1 version. Okay, so just save it and run again. And in the emulator, you just have to restart the conversation. Yeah, there we see our adaptive card. And if you want to visit the website, just click on that and confirm. Yeah. So, for today, I think this much is pretty good. And from tomorrow, we're going to start building our logic. Okay. See you tomorrow, guys. Thank you all.